This carby has seen better days. It's been sitting sadly like this for over 12 years. I've never done a carby rebuild, so I had to do a bit of research on YouTube and found a few detailed videos by Slade's VW Beetle, which I'll use as a guide here. Five screws separate the top and bottom half of the carburettor. It's missing the float lug, which keeps the float in the correct position. The float needle valve will shut off the fuel supply when the float level reaches its maximum. I'm looking for the automatic choke notch, which is used to adjust how long it stays on. There's a spring in this choke diaphragm. I nearly lost it when it came apart. I'll use an ultrasonic cleaner on this with a bit of degreaser. It cleans up nicely. I purchased this kit off Amazon for just over $40 Australian. They're different lengths. I wonder what this means. Washers are used here to adjust the fuel level, and according to the Easy Jeezy, you need to have the following distance from the top of the carburettor to the surface of the fuel, depending on your engine model. Thankfully, a replacement float lug is supplied in this kit, which needs to be correctly positioned with the curved side towards the back. The new choke diaphragm has to go in with the guide holes in the correct position. I forgot the spring. The retaining ring cover needs to have the indents facing the carburettor body. This is the notch I was looking for earlier, and it needs to align somewhere within these three lines as a starting point. I've seen this also referred to as the air cutoff valve. I think this next step is optional. There's a tiny ball bearing under this plug, which can be removed with an M4 screw. It's a bit of a trick to get out, and I'll need to be really careful not to lose that tiny ball bearing. won't forget the spring this time. You can feel and hear when the plug is fully seated. With the idle speed screw all the way in, backing it out 5.5 turns will set it to a good starting point. When bringing the fuel mixture screw all the way in, I'll need to be careful as the point can damage the carburettor body if I take it too far. This can then be rotated around 10 half turns for a good starting point. You get a few different gaskets in this kit, so I'll make sure that everything matches as it should. And that's it. Now I hope it works as good as it looks.